Nigeria has responsibility beyond its borders. Nigeria has responsibility for West Africa, for Africa, and as I always say, for the black race all over the world. That is why we are the largest country with the black race in the world. Our responsibility must go beyond our borders. And at times, as you rightly said, we do things and you look at us and you get worried, which is understandable. But let me assure you and give you what Boutros Ghali said about Nigeria. When they asked him, which country would you like to live in if you are not living in Egypt? And he looked up and said, Nigeria. And the man who questioned him said, Nigeria of all places? Why? Oh, he said, you wake up in the morning in Nigeria and you will think the heaven will fall. And by the time you sleep, you are going to bed in the evening, it is all cool and calm. And that is your country, Nigeria. Let us continue to make it all cool and calm. Now, at this juncture, before I step down, I want to specially acknowledge the presence of my former vice president. I remember in the process of this book was to be unveiled or presented before the primaries, our own party primaries. But because President Jonathan wanted me to partake in this event, he wisely said, let us put this event after the primaries. Because the role I want you to play, if you play that role, they will say, I am endorsing you. So we decided to defer the presentation of this book. But all the same, I can tell you President Jonathan voted for me. Today is a very historic day in this country. And I would want to say that we have been fortunate enough to have had a president who followed the footsteps of the president produced by the People's Democratic Party in this country. In other words, his action or his reaction in the 2015 elections, as has been said here, helped consolidate our democracy. But for that singular action, only God knows where I would have been today. So we celebrate you today, and we celebrate you with your family on this birthday occasion of yours.
This is not my biography. There are definitely some statements about my beginning, primary school, secondary school, you must have crossed a journey started somewhere. And also my activities in government. I just wanted to make a brief contribution of core things about the election. Because whenever I travel, I feel actually, even Nigerians, especially from the diaspora, even some of us back home, you used to ask me, why did you concede debate? Why did you make that phone call? Why didn't you go to court? The book reveals a lot, but if you read the book, you will understand a little more. And that's one of the reasons I feel like writing this. The book centered mainly on the elections. But I debated to mention certain few things, especially certain negative things. Because the life of a government is like the life of an individual. There are some areas that are positive, you also make certain things that are negative. There are certain issues in the government that were used against me during the election. The issue of Boko Haram and Chibokers. In fact, some people even said that I brought Boko Haram to reduce the voting population of the North so that I will win elections. So I commented on the Chibokers. Also the fuel subsidy that was really, really used by the, of course, politicians must exploit opportunities. So I don't blame them. Maybe this myself, probably I will do the same thing. But I needed to explain certain things, so I took that decision. The issues of corruption. Leading young Nigerians to understand the problem of corruption, where it started, or if anybody knows where it could go. But I've made some suggestions to encourage official government. If you are to tackle corruption, how we should all go about it. It's a problem that all of us must face. Maybe I use the opportunity to maybe make a little suggestion also in terms of our election, because the issue of vote buying is becoming scandalous in Nigeria. We know that there is this concept of inducing the electorate, which most countries control. So all the countries have gone to observe elections. Ordinary inducement of the electorate is criminalized, and people don't do it. But here in Nigeria, we take inducing electorate as a part of the democratic process. What I mean by inducing the electorate is that during campaigns, we package rice, salt, with the photograph of the candidates, the logo of the parties, and distribute to people. That is wrong by all international standards. I did not know I got involved in a value election. But those are still being considered as not serious offenses. They are inducing electorate. In most of the African countries, in fact, all the African countries have gone to observe elections. Even in that rally, nobody will give you a pen with the candidate's name on it. All what the candidates and their parties will do is the t-shirts, the face caps for young boys and young girls, and the flags of the party, and the banners, and the flyers. Nobody give you any gift. But in Nigeria, if you don't provide gift, it's like you have not started. But this is not the generation that started it. As a child, I watched those early elections, late 59, 60. People were doing that. We were going to our villages to give salt to women and all those kind of things. And we just graduated from that, inducing the electorate with the outright pricing and buying of votes. That people will go to the polling booth and price 1,000, 2,000, 3,000. In some cases, they are even telling me 5,000 to buy votes. I think the INEC must do everything to stop that. My suggestion is that we should really look at the way we build our polling booths. I think we should begin to do like some other African countries. All the African countries have gone to observe elections. Nobody gives polling booths. They have polling centers, public buildings, especially schools, and use the classrooms. So one school will have so many polling units. And it's easier for the police to police these polling units together. And it's difficult for somebody who is in the classroom to show you the ballot paper. Because you cannot pay somebody until you have access to see the ballot paper. So if you design the electoral process in a way that you cannot see the ballot paper, then the issue of outright vote buying will die. The inducement may continue, you see good rights and so on, but at least that is a minor offense. Maybe that is the only suggestion I would make, that I believe that I next to make.